Hello, this is Dr. Gary Hawkins with the University of Georgia Crop and Soil Science Department and UGA Extension. Today we'll be demonstrating how to use the water and wastewater Enviroscape model. Funding for this video has been in part from Georgia's EPD 319 program. In this video, we want to look at the rural wastewater treatment system using the water and wastewater Enviroscape model. In one of the previous videos, we looked at the urban wastewater treatment plant and how that operates. Here in the rural areas, we don't have a connection to a sewage line, so we have to have sewage collection, processing, and distribution all on the same property. So we'll use the upper right-hand portion of the model. For purposes of this video, I'm going to take our trees off just so we can see what's going on. As you can see, the way this is set up, there's a house, and the house has a hole in the top, so we can actually inject some septic into our system. There's a green felt cover which covers up our septic tank and our leach field lines. So on the model, that's what these three different parts are, and you can look into your manual for additional information. So as you're setting it up, the green cover goes over the leach field or our septic field, and the house would just sit on top, so it looks like a normal ground cover. So the first thing that we're going to do is take the felt off so we can see what's going on underneath. We've taken some red drink mix in a syringe to represent our wastewater that we'll use shortly. This water comes from washing dishes, taking showers, flushing the toilet, and so on. So as we flush our toilet, we would inject some red dye. Typically this red dye, and I'll remove the house now, goes into the collection system and goes into our septic tank itself. So as we get water into our septic tank, the septic tank actually treats that water through an anaerobic process. Anaerobic bacteria, just like an anaerobic digester, if you watch the urban side of the wastewater treatment facility, converts that organic matter to methane and carbon dioxide and reduces the sludge load. From there, we have water coming into the system from bathing and other purposes. That liquid will then go into, as you see, the two channels here in our leach field. This leach field is a perforated pipe and a gravel pack, typically designed based on the number of bedrooms in the house. The system is also based on soil type, so we know the percolation rate of the soil underneath our leach field. So as the wastewater comes out of the house, it goes into our septic tank and goes into our septic or leach field. And in this water then is eventually and evenly distributed across our septic field, and that water infiltrates into our groundwater and aquifer system. One of the things to be aware of is that you definitely do not want your septic system upstream of your aquifer system that you're drawing your clean water from due to the possibility of cross-contamination. Also, septic tanks should be pumped out roughly every 3 to 5 years. This keeps them operating properly and gets the sludge out of the septic tank itself and protects the downstream leach field. With that, this has been our rural septic management and wastewater treatment on the rural area. This is Dr. Gary Hawkins with the University of Georgia and UGA Extension. Thank you.